Good morning, everybody. It's a welcome to the Maintenance Analytics Summit 2020. Actually, it's let me have a few words to explain that this situation is very unprecedented. It's because, of course, the conference was scheduled to be presential, face to face, to do networking, etc., as usual we like to do, but in this occasion, due to the coronavirus, couldn't happen in that way. But it's, I really hope that during this edition of Maintenance Analytics Summit, we're going to have the opportunity to see how the maintenance analytics plays a key role, not only nowadays in 2020, in the fourth industrial revolution, but also with this crisis that we are suffering now, is maintenance analytics plays extremely, extremely important key role. Let me say that we are suffering a very, very unprecedented situation with the pandemic, with the COVID-19, and this is something that we have to be aware of, that is what we call in our common language, the concept of a black swan. It's a, what do I mean with a black swan? It's a black swan, you know, that is not very popular among some researchers, but it is something that is very rare in terms of a probability. It's some researchers don't like this topic, and we have been talking always about the black swan as something that was extremely negative in terms of research. However, the black swan is something that is rare, has extreme impact, and when we can see this event, and the event has already passed, suddenly we find some explanation. It's what we call a retrospective, right? It's, let me say that in this case, a black swan, coronavirus as a black swan, is going to trigger many things in technology, and especially in technology for the industry. And the industry maintenance is going to play a key role in this. Unfortunately, the history of maintenance is also dominated by the black swans. It's, if you recollect the history of the maintenance, the catastrophes that have been higher in impact all over the world, like in Fukushima or Chernobyl or the problem in the Gulf of Mexico. It's all of them, they were black swans for maintenance, and the impact was huge. Actually, we will analyze during this summit how our knowledge bias is going to affect the prediction that we want to do for our assets, and how we need to change the paradigm of maintenance. Actually, this is extremely relevant, that the maintenance perspective, the data-driven perspective, plus the knowledge dimension by the domain knowledge, plus the surprises, that is this kind of events like the black swan, everything constitutes the maintenance knowledge basis. This is very important, because just with data-driven techniques, we cannot do anything. If we add domain knowledge, it's also important, but we have to consider all aspects that eventually may happen in maintenance. And this is very important, because many times you all know that if we pay attention to the normal failures that may happen in our assets, and we pay attention to the normal failures that maybe the severity is not that high, but we know the degradation mechanism, etc., we pay attention to preventive maintenance to mitigate these failures. However, the failures that are really outliers, the failures that don't happen very often, the failures that actually, if you take these failures that almost never happen, and you neglect the importance of these failures, is then we are going to have a problem. And however, if we take these failures that are very rare as one opportunity to make our system more robust and more resilient, then maintenance will play a key role in the next generations. Indeed, if you take the black swans in maintenance as something that is the long tails and corner cases. The black swans in maintenance are these events that are happen time to time. It's a very, very rare. However, when they happen, it's catastrophic. And maybe all the benefit that we have been getting for many years, is the benefit is gone due to this black swan. This is what we have to make our systems more robust in terms of a black swan resilience. And this is extremely important for us, because one important thing in now after this coronavirus is that the maintenance analytics may play an important role to confront the black swans. The black swans that may come from the industry, may come from the society, may come from a virus like the coronavirus that is killing our industries. How we can confront these black swans? We need proper risk assessments. We need robust systems. We need resilience. And of course, our systems cannot be fragile anymore. This is extremely important. Then the way of maintenance analytics is the way of industrial AI. And industrial AI is maybe, at least in my opinion, and we will see during the presentations today, that industrial AI is the way forward to make our systems more robust. More robust in which sense? We are used to work with artificial intelligence in social aspects like Amazon, Google, wherever they profile our likes and dislikes, they make predictions of our market, etc. However, when we talk about industrial AI, we are talking about something different. The industrial AI tries to model our assets, to model our fleet, and to do failure forecasting and performance monitoring. To some extent, the industrial AI and maintenance analytics as a part, important part of industrial AI, they want to do the same that we do with the artificial intelligence in the social media. Indeed, if you compare social media and industrial AI, the suppliers of social media like Google, Facebook, etc., what they do is they learn from data, and of course we learn from data as well. But remember that in maintenance, mostly we are learning from machine-generated data. This is extremely relevant because the data that we are working in maintenance is mostly machine-generated data. And the pipelines that we are working in industrial AI, it's a focus on maintenance analytics, they have to deliver some services. Same services as the services that the consumer is demanding in the normal media. What services we are demanding? We are demanding prognosis, we are demanding diagnosis, we are demanding early warnings for our failures, the proper planning for our maintenance task, etc. And in this case, we have to be aware that the industrial AI with maintenance analytics as a specific part for maintenance is maybe the front-end technology that we have to be aware for the confrontation of these black swans. And let me say, why is it so important maintenance analytics and industrial AI is to confront these black swans? It's very simple. We have been working for many years with different types of analytics, from description to cognition. And so far, our systems were more or less okay. The evolution was okay. But the evolution, let me be honest, the evolution is slow. The expectations we had for 2020 are not here. 2020 is already happening now, and we don't have the deployments that we expected. Why this has not happened? Very simple. We have four basic types of analytics that we have been working for many years, from description to prescription. These basics of analytics are maybe the rudimentary analytics that we have been working from alarm management, diagnosis, maintenance, predictive maintenance, and later on prescription in order to prescribe what to do with the machine in order to enlarge or maximize the remaining useful life of the machine. But this is not enough. Why this is not enough? Because the cognition, that is the last step of our pyramid, is not there. And what do I mean with the cognition? Cognitive analytics is not that different from prescriptive or predictive analytics, but there's one substantial difference. the decisions are taken by machines. And this is what we have to be aware of, that we need now automated decisions for maintenance, because we cannot rely on humans for everything. If you have a fleet of 1,000 or 10,000 assets and you have to take the decision one by one for the maintenance planning, for the prognosis, for the diagnosis, and you have to validate one by one the decisions that you take for each asset and each component or subsystem of the assets, you will get crazy. We need to move to cognition. We need to make mature the technologies we are working from description to prescription, because this is already here, but we have to move definitely to cognition. Why? Because so far, what we have been looking in our data is not enough to make this automation. We have been working with no casting for many years, just looking back in the mirror, what was happening in the past, analyzing the data that I was collecting. This is not enough. We have to go for a forecasting model where I can make some kind of prediction of my future. And this is essential, because then I will be able to move from the corrective maintenance to the PHM, to the prognostic health management. And if you look in this maintenance roadmap that is not new at all, it's this step by step. These jumps are very, very traumatic for some people, because it's, for example, from condition-based maintenance to PHM, the jump is huge. There's a huge gap there, because it's just checking the condition of the machine or predicting the future condition of the machine and act according to the future condition of the machine. And this makes our new maintenance entirely different. But PHM is not enough. We need some kind of automated PHM in order to make the decisions of maintenance automated by industrial AI and have PHM powered by AI. And this is important in terms of maturity as well, because the industry, we are moving to this kind of model. We need more diagnosis and prognosis, and we need less traditional preventive maintenance. And that's why the traditional maintenance plans of the companies are moving towards this kind of a maintenance mix. But if the technology is not mature enough, how can we rely on these technologies? Because if we are saying that, okay, we have to do that shift of maintenance from traditional preventive maintenance to PHM, prescriptive, and even cognitive, we need to rely on the technologies, and we need confidence on these technologies. Then, definitely, during this conference, we are going to see how we are moving to cognitive analytics in order to have automated decisions for our maintenance systems. And the reason to have automated decisions for our maintenance systems is because we cannot rely on humans for all the decisions. Let me be honest. This is something that is extremely tough many times to mention, but Industry 4.0 intends to make some process more automated in terms of AI, not the third industrial revolution, but of course the humans will play a key role, but a more relevant role in terms of skills and qualifications. But the low qualified people, if possible, will be removed from the shop floor level. And this is extremely important to understand, that the cognitive analytics tries to make maintenance fully automated. It's true that many times the technology is ahead of the regulation, and talking about this kind of concept sounds like very futuristic. But now with the coronavirus, we see that we need automated systems in order to make our factories and our energy assets, our railways, everything independent from humans. What is the biggest achievement now in terms of mobility? It's autonomous vehicles, because we cannot rely on humans for certain things. Autonomous vehicles is a robotics in manufacturing, is unattended systems and unmanned systems. This is what we have to be aware that artificial intelligence is going to help us a lot. And our ambition is what we call the dark factory. The dark factory is the factory that, okay, you can switch off the lights, and there are no humans there. Just operational maintenance is performed by the assets and by robots, etc. Why the ambition is to have the dark factory? Because if we have the problems that we have had with coronavirus and these months you have suffered that, is how are you guaranteeing that our factories, our energy systems, our transportation systems are going to keep on working in spite of the people that are getting sick? We need unmanned systems where not only the operation is automated, but also the concept of maintenance. And for that, there's something that is very, very common, is the concept of digital twin. It's something that we have to be aware that is there. And this concept came here to stay with us for many years. What do I mean with this? The concept of digital twin is this co-creation of knowledge where we are going to have more automated systems and the cognitive analytics is going to be a reality. These models, the digital twins for maintenance, are going to play extremely key role for us. The extremely key role that is going to deliver a number of services in automated way. And this is extremely important because the digital twins, instead of something like a BIM model, etc., for maintenance have some kind of a special meaning. It's a service provider. The digital twins for us is a real service provider where we are going to put our resources, and the digital twin, by the means of maintenance analytics, is going to help us to take the proper maintenance decisions in automated way. And let me tell you that the real ambition that we need in maintenance is the picture of Dorian Gray. What we intend to have in terms of digital twins for maintenance is, you may remember the book of the picture of Dorian Gray, is that this gentleman makes one deal with the evil, and it's okay. The deal is that he will be forever young, and the aging effect, the degradation, will be just shown in the picture that he keeps hidden at home, and he can see how the degradation is of himself is in the picture, but he keeps himself forever young. This is what we want for our assets. We want our assets forever young, and we want to see the degradation in our digital twins. And this is extremely important because if we look at the concept of digital twin with this Dorian Gray metaphor, we have to introduce not only the end users to create these digital twins. The digital twins have to be created by the end users that can provide the data and the manufacturers and designers. For example, here you have the typical military information flow, where actually the air forces, they are the end users. They provide the data to the manufacturer, and the manufacturer improves the design and manufacturing. What do I mean with this? The digital twin is the co-creation of end users together with designers and manufacturers, because we cannot just create a digital twin from one side. In summary, the digital twin is something that covers the whole spectrum of the life cycle of our assets. Indeed, the life cycle of our assets is covered in the digital twin, because we need to integrate, and this is important for maintenance analytics, we need to integrate not only the information of operation and maintenance that is for the end user, also the design and manufacturing. This makes that our supply chains are more complex, and the collaboration is absolutely needed. We need the collaboration between designers and manufacturers together with end users to co-create this digital twin solution. We started in the beginning talking about IT and OT convergence, and this is important. It's because we cannot have just digital twins based on OT or IT technologies. This is something that we have to move forward, and we need the convergence of the shop floor level together with the IT level. But let me tell you one thing. This was some part of Industry 4.0, very disruptive, but not definitely enough. What do I mean with that? It's last year in the conference, we had the chance to see how the domain knowledge is extremely important. Extremely important because the domain knowledge is the domain knowledge that complements the data-driven knowledge. It's when we are in maintenance, our data sets are incomplete. It's we don't have data of our failures. And this is very unfortunate, but it's the ugly truth. We need data. The more data, the less downtime. This was our slogan last year. However, the more data, less downtime. But you need also some qualified type of data. And it's the domain knowledge data. For advanced stages of degradation that you don't have records, and you need the domain knowledge there. That's why the domain knowledge is essential to move from the traditional digital twins to a robust digital twin that can perform maintenance analytics. And then we can move to the real digital twin, that is when the OT and IT converge with ET, with the engineering technology. Then when we have all the knowledge, the operational technologies, information technologies, and also the engineering technologies, and we have this kind of a spectrum of failures totally covered, then we can say that the black swans can be minimized, and we are mitigating the risk of the black swans. Because this is the most important thing that we have to be aware of. When we try to converge all the technologies to have a model that predicts the failures and takes the decisions, of course, the data that you are using for this prediction is extremely important, and you need to bring to this kind of a digital twin that you are cooking, you need to bring all knowledge, including the engineering knowledge that may help you for problems like the black swan. And in this regard, we will see during this conference, talking people in the end user side, in the designer manufacturer side, but we have to be aware that end users and designers and manufacturers have to co-create the solution, must collaborate in order to create this digital twin that is the main point where the maintenance analytics is going to be performed. Indeed, we have to be aware that the digital twins in terms of maintenance is what we call the concept of PLM, the PLM product life management, that is something that we have to be aware that in maintenance analytics is very, very essential. What do I mean with a PLM? PLM is something that considers the asset during the whole life cycle. And to do maintenance analytics, you need to consider the asset during the entire life cycle, because it's essential for us to consider the beginning, even the conceptual creation of the asset, because some of the infant mortality failures may come from the design and manufacturing, and I have to correct these failures during the operation. And definitely, some weaknesses during the manufacturing of the asset will pop up during the utilization of the asset. Then this is important in terms of digital twin, but it's not enough. It's not enough because the industrial AI, by the means of maintenance analytics, has to help us to discover not only the failures that I'm used to see. If I may have a catalog of failures that is very complete, but I need to be aware that there are many failures that I'm not aware of the existence of these failures. And the industrial AI has to help us to see the invisible things. And if the maintenance analytics can help us to identify unknown things for me, invisible mechanism of degradation, things that I didn't consider in the beginning, then I will have covered many black swans, and I will have mitigated what we can call the digital butterfly effect that we had last year the chance to listen in our conference in Maintenance Analytics Summit 2019. Because the problem is we cannot cope with that complexity. The human being cannot cope with that complexity, and it's extremely important that the maintenance analytics for root cause analysis, they are essential in order to define what is the origin of the problem. And the complexity of the assets make us so vulnerable to that the definitely maintenance analytics and industrial AI is the only way to mitigate the digital butterfly effect. And in this case, you will listen to me many times mentioning the concept of digital twin, but don't think of digital twin as a 3D representation of something. No, the digital twin for us is the model. The model that has to help us to predict and to take the proper decisions. The digital twin is the service provider. And on top of this digital twin, I can take some services like augmented reality, I can take spare parts management, etc. And this is extremely important. The digital twin is something that provides value to the entire supply chain. And in this aspect, we have to be aware that the digital twins is something that we have to take to move to the dark factory, because the digital twins with this kind of Dorian Gray model that I explained you is something that will help us to have a model of our assets, make the predictions of our assets, take the proper decisions in automated way. We don't need to have decisions one by one for each asset. Imagine, for example, in a refinery where you may have 10,000 centrifugal pumps. Are you going to take the decisions of maintenance one by one? No, definitely no. We need something more robust that is helping to take these maintenance decisions. And the digital twin is going to help us with that. Definitely the digital twin converts what we call the digital ILS approach. What do I mean with the ILS approach? ILS means integrated logistic support. And the digital twin is something that we have to be aware that what we intend to do is we want to provide services. Once the model is created, the data has come to the model, the information from design and manufacturing have come to the model, this model have to deliver some services. And the integrated logistic support is exactly this military concept for this servitization. What do I mean with that? What we want in digital twins is to deliver services to provide the maximum performance for our assets. We want to forecast the failures and we want to maximize the performance. What I mean is that if you have a factory, if you have a boat, if you have a train, what you want with your digital twin is to provide the maintenance decisions in terms of spare parts management, in terms of labor force, in terms of shutdown management, in order to maximize the performance of these assets. And all the logistics around the asset is what we call logistics support. And the digital twin has to help us not only predicting the failure, but also managing the health of our assets with this kind of logistics support. And believe me, if we can get that, the amount of assets that we are working will benefit. We have to move for among assets. Unattended assets is something that we have to move forward to that. If you look, for example, the energy sector, and you look the windmills are almost unattended assets. You don't need anyone there to take care of the maintenance or operation of these windmills. If you go for example, for the transportation systems, we are working for cars, for buses, for trains that are fully autonomous, and you don't need driver anymore. And hopefully, you will not need maintenance people anymore either. And this is very important. And in our factories also, we need this kind of unattended systems. Robotics in maintenance, powered by maintenance analytics and industrial AI, is playing a key role to convert our systems in unattended systems. And when these systems become unattended, and this crisis like coronavirus pop up, we will be totally safe, because our systems, our manufacturing, our transportation will not shut down because our people will get sick. Unfortunately, the systems we have now, they have been proven very, very fragile because people getting sick, the system shut down. With these unattended systems and unmanned systems powered by maintenance analytics, definitely we will have this kind of constraints much more solved. It's definitely this is going to be something extremely traumatic for some people. We are going to see during this conference how the maintenance analytics is going to move forward. It's going to move forward to artificial intelligence aspects, digital twins, and other things in order to make the maintenance totally automated. And definitely, maintenance is something that is going to change dramatically the coming years because we need extremely powerful maintenance analytics in order to make our systems robust and not fragile in order to mitigate the problems of a coronavirus and other crisis that may come. Because I repeat, if our systems become robust and resilient and we don't need humans to operate and maintain these assets, definitely our assets will not shut down due to any kind of black swan. Thank you very much, and I really hope that you enjoy the day of today with the excellent speakers that we have for all the panels. We will see during the day how the maintenance is changing and is mutating a lot, and it's definitely is a transition that is not a transformative, neither disruptive. It's something different, and we are moving to a new maintenance era. Thank you very much. Okay, before we go into the next presentation, I just answer one question that I have in the folder. It's the slides as usual, and will be available if the presenters give their permission for the attendees, and the organization will contact you to provide all the information later on. Thank you very much and enjoy the conference.